All right, good morning, guys. For those who are visiting the Death Valley, I just want to give you guys a quick tour of the ranch at the Death Valley. It's a beautiful resort. A lot of people here. Well, if you're here, chances are you might want to stay here. So this is the main entrance. As you come in, you pull off through here, and this is where the registration happens, or town hall, as they call it. You can park your vehicle just like this one here. Get inside and take care of your checking business. My wife and we were kind of lucky because they were able to let us check in early. So if you're here early and you know you want to get in, come here and do ask them. And the nice part about it is there's a lot of flags from different countries, and it's pretty nice overall. And I'll talk in details about the rest. I don't know if it's going to be noisy because it is pretty windy this morning. Am I recording? Yeah, I am. So as you come around, I will talk to you guys about this later. So there is the Oasis Shoppe. Most of these shops, they open late in the afternoon and they close also pretty early. And this is directly behind the registration. So as you come in, you will either, I mean, this is the only way to get in here. There's a parking lot over there, which we will go see. There's several of them actually. So this is at the directly behind complex. It's pretty nice to come here and sit in the evening with the kids. We stayed here for a bit and it was, you know, really nice and peaceful. This is the, I would say the main attraction here. Well, not an attraction, but the main. So now I'm gonna take you guys over to the restaurant to the left. So just bear with me. Okay, so this is the restaurant, 1849. It is open. I saw people here last night. So you can come have your dinner, whatnot. I won't be going inside this. My idea is to give you a tour of the resort. So again, breathtaking views. And the good thing here is the streets are named after like the major attraction points around Death Valley, like Zebrinsky Point, Furnace Creek, and so on. So, and here is your general store where you can come and buy whatever you like. I don't know if you can get soft drinks and stuff. Not sure about alcohol. So do some research. And this is one parking lot. There, if you have electric car, this is not where you're gonna be parking. There's this parking lot at the back on that side, which I'll take you guys over there. But before I do that, I wanna talk to you about this Borax Museum very quickly. So let's take a look at that. Okay, so this is the Borax Museum. So if you have rooms that are in the 400 to 900s, it's gonna be on your left. The new huts are to our right. I'll take you guys later. But I just wanna show you this Borax Museum. I didn't see people here, but you can come. And this directly behind is the outdoor Borax Museum. If you have kids, you're welcome to walk around, have fun, let them see things. I'm not gonna bother showing everything here, but quite the fun, to be honest. So next is we're gonna check out the 400s and the 900 numbers. So these are quite old. I'll stay on this shade. So I think maximum capacity here is 4 at max. But if you're 6, they built the new resorts or the cottage style resorts, which I'm staying in one, brand new. In fact, they opened up only this year, so let me go there. So as you can see on the board, guest rooms 400 to 900 is this side. There's a horseback carriage and there's a pool and tennis. So let's go check that out. This is the same parking lot. So from that general store, it's the same view, or Scorpion Lane. And this is the way for 400 to 900. Again, a small rooms. I have no idea how they even look inside. But I have another video of the cottage style, the newly one that they built that I'm staying in. You're welcome to take a look at that. Anyways, so this is a short walk across here to reach the pool. So I'm gonna stop here and then continue when I reach the tennis area and the pool. So more parking for you all here. Again, park closer to your room so that you don't have to end up walking. And word of advice, guys, when you're driving around here, please drive slow. There are lots of kids near the pool and they're running around it. And at night, the visibility here is not the greatest. So you always want to be safe. It's important. So if you have room 800, it will be on your right here. And 900 is here. And again, plenty of parking. So I'm gonna go show you guys the stable. Just bear with me. Okay, I'm gonna make this very quick. So this is your Furnace Creek Ranch stable. I didn't even bother to come around this side. So if you need to check it out, you're welcome to check it out. Now let's go check out the pool. Sorry, before I go to the pool, I want to quickly show you guys the park area for kids. If you want to come and let them run around and play, you're welcome to do so. And it is located directly behind the pool area. As you can see, it's pretty nice, especially in the evening when the sun is down. It's a great place to be. So there's the pool. I forgot what time they open at, but I know that they close every night at 11 p.m. and there are no lifeguards on duty. So if you have kids, please stay with them or send an adult to keep an eye on them. I stayed here with my kids last night till about at least 10 a.m. in the morning. Oh, it looks like the pool is open and it's only 6 or 7 in the morning. I see someone in there already. Anyways, sorry about the noise, guys, the wind noise and whatnot. And look at this tree. Humongous. Anyways, so the pool on your left, and then you have basketball and tennis over here. Could be a little difficulty finding it. You have to walk all the way to the back of this resort to find this, but it's not difficult. And here is what they call the service road. So if you want to reach the pool quickly, just take the service road all the way to your back. So now I'm going to stop and show you guys the parking lot for the electric car chargers and whatnot, and then the new cottage style resorts, and that would be it. So again, to make it easy for people, just remember that's the way you see the car at the far back. So it's called the service road. Just take the service road, walk all the way, and you'll reach the pool. At night, again, very minimal lighting, so be careful. See, it's called the service road for a reason, because of all the service vehicles. So now I'm walking back up. This is the Borax Outdoor Museum, and to my left, which I will come around shortly, is the parking for, actually, you know what, let me go through here. Don't do this, guys. All right, so this is a this will be the closest parking lot here and there, if you're staying in those newly built cottage style apartments. And here's your reserved parking for all your Tesla fans and Volts and Polestar and you name it. This is for you. Obviously it's reserved, you're not supposed to be parking here. And now, to end this tour, I'm gonna show you guys these newly built cottage style apartments. And again, I apologize for the strong wind, but as you can see, it is beautiful. And guess who I see? My son outside. So that's where I'm staying. I have another video of the inside if you guys want to look. And overall, guys, you can walk all the way to the back. The view is same to your left and right. Liam, careful. Just a beautiful resort. We had a great time here. And there's my wife sitting and having her coffee. That's it. Thanks for watching, guys. All right, so these are the newly built apartments here at the ranch. And I think there's two, one here, one on the other side. But as you can see, they are all identical.
Bite daddy.
Yeah, boo boo.
Then bite and swallow your finger. That means chew. Do yeah. You hear daddy?
Yeah, you can walk. Again, this is just in between. I'm right behind you.
Are you going the same way that you went?
And cars passing by is the highway or freeway 190. So I can only imagine people staying here. You may, maybe a little more noisier for you guys. Okay, here, let's go this way. And again, as you can see, exactly the same. Well, they need water, right? Well, it's all done automatically, right? And
Daddy.
This is it, guys.